first full day of competition here at Universiade in Guangzhou. There you see the Universiade cauldron laid atop the main stadium. In today's headlines, we'll start with diving, the men's 3-meter springboard action. Can China dominate again? Also, 4 medals being awarded in judo competition. We'll head to the pool. Swimming gets underway with 3 medals to be awarded here today. Relays and the 400-meter individual medley. And in fencing, have the men's saber and the women's épée. And also basketball action as Germany takes on China. From the Nambu University Aquatic Center, men's diving, the 3-meter springboard final.
Cameras and noises can disturb them.
First up with a forward 2.5 somersault with 2 twists. This is Peng Jian Feng of China. Very nice clean entry there by Peng. They score 91.80 on that dive. If we get a replay of it.
9. Total score 91.8.
Very clean entry. Now a reverse 3.5 somersault for Peng. Again, a strong entry for Peng. He continues to lead. He's up to 259.30.
Yevgeny Novoselov, Russia.
Now a forward 2.5 somersault with 2 twists. This is Evgeny Novoselov of Russia. Another solid entry. These divers having a strong day here today in the 3-meter springboard. Score of 86.70 for the Russian.
8.5.
We got a good slow motion view of it. And now this is Daniel Islas Arroyo of Mexico. His strong dive there. It's 79.95. The overhead view that these divers see as they enter the water.
Tomorrow's competition is women's platform
followed by Novoselov,
at 11 o'clock.
And then Islas Arroyo of Mexico with the bronze. First day of judo action here at Universiade, Yeomju Bitgyul Gymnasium here in Gwangju. First up, the women's under 78 kilogram gold medal bout. Sama Hawa Kamara of France taking on Elena Petrikovskaya of Russia. Kamara in white, Petrikovskaya in blue. There's the Yuko scored by Kamara. She won gold at a World Cup event in late May. Now she just has to hold on here. See if she can claim gold. Time ticking down, and it will be Kamara winning the gold medal. Petrovskaya of Russia will take the silver. Park and Mikey Zeik will take bronze. Now the women's over 78 kilogram class. Sarah Asahina of Japan, taking on Kim Jong of Korea in white. Asahina won last year's World Junior Championship gold in Fort Lauderdale in the United States. And there, the epon score by Asahina.
Tom Sihu, 남자 마이너스 100kg 시상식을 시작하겠습니다.
And that will be enough to give her a gold medal. Kim will take the silver. Takenti of Lithuania, the bronze, and Kang of China, also bronze. Moving on now to the men's under 100 kilogram class. This is Fernando Herrera of France and Cho Guam of Korea. There was a silver medalist at the University of back in 2011 in Shenzhen, China. Another one given there. Hey! Down. It's going to be those three shingles that give the Korean the gold medal here at home in Gwangju. Jamal Delbert will claim his second Universiade silver medal.
This was Tularov from Russia.
There you see the bronze going to Pfeiffer and Bilalov.
Double.
Now the men's over 100 kilogram class. Hisayoshi Harasawa of Japan taking on Magomed Najmudinov of Russia. Harasawa in white, Najmudinov in blue. The Russians finished fifth in Shenzhen 2011. Harasawa coming off a gold medal at the European Open event in Rome in February. And in the end, it's the four Shidos collected by Najmudinov that will give Harasawa the gold medal. There you see him collecting his hardware. Najmudinov will take silver. Nabil Jalag of France and Vladuc Simonescu of Romania each take bronze. Swimming gets underway here today in Gwangju at the Nambu University Aquatic Center. First up, the women's 400 meter individual medley final. Sarah Henry, potential favorite here from the United States. She won silver in the 200 meter individual medley and gold on the 4x200 meter freestyle relay team at Kazan in 2013. And there you see Henry pulling away. She's going to swim to another gold medal. Sarah Henry finishes first in a time of 4:38.88. Barbara Zabadova of the Czech Republic will take silver. And Haley Flickinger, also of the United States, she will claim bronze. Now time for the women's 4x100 meter freestyle relay. Defending gold medalists are Russia in lane 5. But it is the Americans well out in front as they make that final turn. That is Lee and Neal pulling away. Japan trying to hang on to silver. Russia right now in the third bronze medal spot. You see a tight battle there for silver and bronze. But it will be the Americans. 3:38.12 seconds. They claim gold in a very tight finish. Japan will take the silver medal. Russia will claim bronze. The Americans set a new Universiade record here today with that time of 3:38.12 seconds. Abigail Weitzel, Shannon Vreeland, Madeline Locust, and Leah Neal, the gold medalists for the Americans. And there you see the final standings. We'll now move to the men's 4x100 meter freestyle relay. United States in lane 4 won gold in this event in 2011. The Russians in lane 6. They're the defending gold medalists from Kazan in 2013. There you see the Americans well out in front. And they make the final turn. Seth Stubblefield, who swims back home to the California Golden Bears. He will bring it home to the United States with a large lead. Japan and Russia again battling here for the silver and bronze medal spots. Americans claim gold, and Japan just ahead of the Russians will take the silver, just over 2 seconds behind the United States. Matthew Ellis, Michael Rinalda, John Conyer, and Seth Stubblefield, the four swimmers for the Americans. And there you see the final results here in the men's 4x100-meter freestyle relay. There you see them both claim their gold medals. A dominant day for the Americans. They won 24 swimming medals in Kazan, including 6 gold. They're already halfway to that total here with the 3 gold medals tonight in Guangzhou. Fencing action, the women's Apei final from the Kim Dae-jung Convention Center here in Guangzhou. This final features Demody Laurence Apei of France and Victoria Kuzmenkova of Russia. In Apei, the entire body is the target, so you'll see the athletes able to score points when contact is made anywhere on their opponent. Apei beat Nelly Padu of Estonia to get to this final. She trailed actually 13-12 in that bout before coming out on top. While Kuzmenkova defeated Yulia Lukagina, also of Russia, 15-12 in her semifinal. 7-5, Apei leading. There's another point for the Frenchwoman. And Apei builds on her lead again, 11-9, now 12-9. As she inches closer to that gold medal. 1 point away now. Kuzmenkova scores there to keep her hopes alive. And again, a quick attack from Kuzmenkova. She's only down one, 14-13. And there, a great lunging attack from Apei, and that'll be enough to give her the gold medal. You can see by the smile on her face and the reaction of her teammates, she is thrilled by that 15-14 win. As her teammates now hoist her in the air. Apei, the gold medalist. Kuzmenkova takes silver. Nelly Padu of Estonia will take a bronze medal, as will Yulia Lukagina of Russia. And there is Apei to the top of the podium, receiving her medal. And there, the flag of France raised to the rafters here in Guangzhou, and a few tears on the face of Apei as she is the gold medalist. We move on now to men's individual saber. This bout features Song Jung-hoon of Korea taking on Dmitry Danilenko of Russia. Song defeated Leonardo Affede of Italy to get to this final. He won that bout 15-5. While Danilenko won 15-6 over Ferenc Valkai of Hungary to get to this final. Now 7-4 in favor of Song. And an attack there from Danilenko makes it 7-4. Now 7-5. Danilenko moves closer, but Song scores one there to go up 8-6. There, a quick counter by Song to score. But a bit of a dispute in terms of who actually won the point, but it is Song who is given that point. Another simultaneous score. and a discussion with the officials. And this time the point is awarded to the Russian. Song there scores to move up 11-8. And another one there to move up now 12-9. And that point there secures Song Jong-hoon the gold medal, 15-12. He defeats Dmitry Danilenko, who will win silver. The Fede of Italy and Valkai of Hungary will each win bronze medals. Song was also second at the 2014 Asian Under 23 Championships held in the Philippines, and he can now add this gold medal as he sees the Korean flag raised here to the top of the convention center. He is the gold medal winner in men's individual saber. Basketball action in the Dongkang College Gymnasium as Germany taking on China in Group A action. Pick up the highlights, China up 22-20. Here's Geske, works his way through, a great little pass there to Thiemann, who will finish it off with the dunk. You see that late little pass, and Johannes Thiemann finishes it off in style. Now Germany's built up a 12-point lead. China trying to stay in it. Liu Hongbo fouled there by Klein, but he'll finish it off with the left hand. Nice play there by Liu. Germany up 56-47. Here's Maldo Low with the steal and the score on the break. Again, Germany, 3-on-1. That finish there, but a nice tip by Halkor. And the foul on China. 67-56. Pass out, here's Halkor again. Knocks down the three. Germany starting to pull away. There you see, nice form on that three-pointer. Now Konstantin Klein gets that screen up top. He'll step back and knock down a three-pointer. Uncontested, Germany up big. China, another strip, and here's a steal, Klein away. He'll finish that one off, 86-61. The Chinese coach looking on, a little bit frustrated. Germany at the buzzer, knocks down another one. They will win this one, 91-64, as they pull away in the fourth quarter to win their opening match here in Guangzhou. There you see 28-12 in the fourth quarter. They outscore China to win this one big. Committed no crime and bad mistakes. I've made a few. I've had my share.